Okay, this sermon is entitled Refuting Flat Earth Stupidity. I'd like to open up with prayer and then with a few verses. All right, dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners, I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Psalm 117 reads, O praise the Lord, all ye nations, praise him, all ye people, for his merciful kindness is great toward us, and the truth of the Lord endureth forever. Praise ye the Lord. Now, this is a subject that I find to be actually embarrassingly stupid. This idea that we have a flat earth as opposed to a circular earth, or better known as the geocentric model versus the heliocentric. So I'm going to basically refute this teaching with about 12 different points here. Number one, moon shadows. The moon's shadow upon the earth's surface has a curvature, reflecting a spherical earth. A flat earth would only exhibit a flat shadow. Number two, slanted stick shadows. If you were to lodge a pole into the ground vertically on a flat earth, the shadow would be rectilinear or perpendicular. On a spherical earth, it has a slight pitch to it or a slight slant, proving that the earth is circular. Number three, other planets in the solar system are spherical, so why is the earth an anomaly or a so-called aberration? It's a good question. Number four, time zones would not exist without hemispheres. In other words, you couldn't have one side of the earth completely blackened by the lack of sunlight and the other side completely lightened by it. Okay, the next point is that the flat earth model makes God look like an idiot. It makes God look like a poor or shoddy designer. Why would he create a flat disc-like earth over a, or as opposed to a, you know, an aesthetical, you know, spherical earth? Okay, the next point is that a flat earth would have no center of gravity, considering that discs have no circumferential center. Number seven, a flat earth would have no centrifugal force. Number eight, these flat earthers resort to crazy ostrobogulous theories and conspiracy theories, basically. They say stuff like NASA's been hiding the fact that they know the Earth is flat for decades, and they've been forging fake portraits of the Earth, you know, satellite-taken portraits with CGI technology or Photoshop, and they've been lying about it for decades. It's a bunch of stupidity. You'd have to be an idiot to believe this. Okay, the next point is that flat earthers posit that there's no gravity. And this is ridiculous because without gravity, there's no hydrostatic equilibrium or homeostasis, you know, to hold the oceans together. On a flat earth, there would be no oceans at all. Okay, and finally, rockets on a flat earth would have no arc-like trajectory. They would just shoot straight up perpendicularly into space. But as we've seen rockets launch, we know that they all veer off depending on where they're positioned. So this just proves that the earth is not flat. My final point is that the Bible does not teach a flat earth. Turn over to Isaiah chapter number 40. In Isaiah chapter 40, we see in verse 22, now before I get into the verse, I'd like to basically explain that, see, God is omnipresent, omnipotent, omniscient, and omnibenevolent. Therefore, God sees the earth from all angles. Now, in order for God to see the earth as flat, he would have to be on top of the earth only, looking straight down with a bird's eye view or a bird's eye vantage point. And therefore, he would see, you know, a circular disc. But see, God sees it from every angle. And therefore, the Bible says that in verse 22, it is he that sitteth upon the circle of the earth, and the inhabitants thereof are as grasshoppers, that stretcheth out the heavens as a curtain, and spreadeth them out as a tent to dwell in. So God sees the earth as a circle, right there, it's clear. Now, why do people believe this garbage? Well, number one, they're brain dead. Number two, they just want attention. They want to be part of some kind of a fringe cult or some type of a sectarian group of people that believe a certain way. It's very cult-like, and I would have to say that they're all idiots. I mean, even MacGyver said that at one point in time, everybody thought the earth was flat. The point he was trying to make was that people are stupid on a global level, on a universal level. That's why people will believe anything. So watch out for all this garbage. Watch out for people that try to say the earth is flat in light of all this evidence when the earth is not flat, because, I mean, that's an embarrassment. So that's all I have. Let me go ahead and close in prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says on this very important subject. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.